that for the past few months, those people who belong to the Indian subcontinent, and now it has spread internationally, you know of the issue of Sania Mirza. Have you heard of Sania Mirza? Wow, wow, mashallah. See, everyone knows. Why? Because of the media. Everyone knows of Sania Mirza. Why? Because of the media. And the media gave her publicity. You know why? Why? Because she was a Muslim. Not only because she was a Muslim, because she was a Muslim and wearing clothes, skirts and shorts. It happened so that last issue of Time magazine, I think it was the last week of September or the first week of October 2005, she came on front page, Sania Mirza front page, wearing a skirt and playing tennis. Why? You know why? All of us know. For the past couple of months, the media was giving a hype. The fatwa was there that what clothes she's wearing, the mini skirts, is haram. It is prohibited. And there's a big hue and cry. All the media, all the television channels going to Muslim ulamas and scholars. Is it right or wrong? And most of them saying haram, 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 and blowing it out of proportion. This is what the media does. It uses information and the way it presents it. So non-Muslim will think, what kind of a religion is this? There is a sportswoman and the religion is trying to stop her. What is there in Islam is haq. We can't change it. What is wrong is wrong. But how do you convey the message is important. Allah says in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 125, Udu ila sabili rabbika bil hikma wal ma'azit al hasna wajadun billati hasan. Invite all to the way of thy Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them and reason with them in the ways that are best and most gracious. When I was given the opportunity, I normally don't speak to the media. I've got my own reasons to the normal media, and I'll tell you why later on. But we normally have a weekly gathering in Bombay where I handle question and session. There are a few hundred people who gather there. And then this question was asked to me, and I told him that you should know how to reply to the media. My first question to the international media is that why are you going and asking the Muslim ulama, the Muslim shuyukh, the Muslim scholars, whether the clothes Sania Mirza is wearing is right or wrong? She is only 34th seed. How much? 34th seed. Why don't you go and ask the Christian priest about Serena Williams? Serena Williams is seed number one. Why don't you go and ask the Christian priest that what clothes Serena Williams is wearing is right or wrong? Why don't you ask? Why don't you go and ask the Pope in Vatican that the clothes Serena Williams and most of the people above Sania Mirza, 33, majority are Christians. Why don't you go and ask the Christian priest and the Pope the clothes she's wearing is right or wrong? If you read the Christian Bible, the Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 22, verse number 5, the woman shall not wear clothes that which pertaineth to a man, and a man shall not wear woman's clothes. All those who do that are an abomination to the Lord. It's mentioned in the 1 Timothy chapter number 2, verse number 9, that the woman should be dressed up modestly with sobriety. They should not wear braided hair or gold or pearls or costly array. A Christian woman is supposed to be covered. You see the example of the nuns. How are the nuns? The nuns are dressed up like the Muslimah. If you have seen the photograph of Mother Mary, may Allah be pleased with her, she's completely covered from head to toe. Only her face and hands up to the wrist is seen. You go and ask the Pope or the Christian priest, if a nun takes out her hijab and if she plays tennis in the skirts, what fatwa will you give? What opinion will you give?